question. The question is, a circus tent is to be erected in the form of a cone surmounted on a cylinder. So circus tent is like that. There is one cylinder and there is a cone surmounted on that. Now the question is saying the total height of the tent. So this is the circus tent, and the total height of this tent is 49 meter. So the total height is given 49 meter, and the diameter. And the diameter is, so diameter will be this. So diameter is given you as 42. The height of cylinder. So the height of cylinder is this. It is given 21 meter. Find the cost of canvas needed to make the tent if the cost of canvas is this. So first of all, for canvassing this circus tent, you have to find out the surface area, curved surface area, not the total surface area. Curved surface area means this surface and this surface. So first of all, you have to find the curved surface area of this cone and then the cylinder, and from that, when you will add both the curved surface area, you will find the total curved surface area of this tent. So what is the curved surface area of a cone? Curved surface area of cone is pi r l. R, you know, if diameter is 242, r will be 21, and this height will be 49 minus 21, that is 28. So this is my 28 and this is my L. So for finding out the curved surface area of the cone, you should have the L, that is slant height. So L square will be equal to 28 ka whole square plus 21 ka whole square by the Pythagoras theorem, because this is the right angle triangle. This is like this. This is 21, this is 28, and you have to find this hypotenuse, that is slant height. So 28 square is 784 plus 441, and it will be equal to 1225. So L square is 1225, so L will be equal to 35. Okay, so L is 35. Now you can find the curved surface area for this. So curved surface area is equal to pi is 22 by 7 into r. R is 21 and 35 this. So 7 3 ja. So that will be equal to 66 into 35. This will be equal to 2310 meter square. So curved surface area of the cone is 2310 meter square. After that, you have to find the curved surface area of this cylinder. Now let us find out the curved surface area of the cylinder. So curved surface area of cylinder is equal to 2 pi r h. So put the value 2 into 22 by 7, r is 21. H, height of the cylinder is also 21. Cancel it out, it will be 44 into 63. So we got the curved surface area of cylinder is 2772 meter square. Now we have the curved surface area of cone and cylinder. We can find the curved surface area of this circus tent. What we have to do, we have to add both the curved surfaces. Total curved surface area of circus tent will be 2310 plus 2772. So that will be equal to 802 718 3710 5082 meter square. So this is the total curved surface area of tent. Now for 1 meter square, the cost is 12.5 rupees. So for 5082 meter square, the cost will be 5082 into 12.5, and you will multiply multiply this, it will come 63525 rupees. So this will be the answer. 63,525 will be. Now we have the next question. The next question is the exterior angles of a pentagon. Pentagon has the five sides. So it will look like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. It will look like this. In the ratio this. First of all, you should always remember the sum of all the exterior angles will be always 360. Either it is quadrilateral, pentagon, hexagon, in any geometrical 2D figure, the sum of exterior angle will be always equal to 360. So sum of exterior angles is equal to 360 degree. And what are the exterior angles? Exterior angle is this. If this is the interior, so this is exterior. This is the interior, then this is exterior. This is interior, then this is exterior. Like this, this only. This is the interior, then this is exterior. This is the interior, then this is exterior. So this interior, this exterior, interior, exterior. So sum of exterior and interior, exterior plus interior will be always equal to 180 degree. You can see exterior plus interior is 180, exterior plus interior is 180. 180. So these two things, if you know, you can solve this question. So exterior angles of a pentagon are in the ratio this. So as I told you, if you have given the ratio, just convert into the numbers as 6x, 3x, 4x, 3x, and 2x. So all the five angles will be 6x plus 3x plus 4x plus 3x plus 2x. And sum of all the exterior angle will be always equal to 360. So just add all these. Now all these angles, 6, 3, 9, 13, 3, 16 plus 18. So 18x will be equal to 360. And here you can find x is equal to 20. So if x is 20, then the exterior angle will be 120 degree, 60 degree, 80 degree, 60 degree, because this is 6 into 20, 3 into 20, 4 into 20, 3 into 20, and 2 into 20 is 40 degree. These are the exterior angles. But in the question, he has asked you interior angles. So exterior and interior angle sum is 180 degree. So if you know the exterior angle, you can find the interior angle how? Just subtract it from 180. So 180 minus 120, that is 60 degree. 180 minus 60, that is equal to 120 degree. 180 minus 80 is 100 degree. 180 minus 60 is 120 degree. 180 minus 40 is 140 degree. So these are the interior angle of this pentagon. Now we have the next question. Which of the following cannot be the sides of a triangle? If I have a triangle, I told you, for making a triangle, the sum of any two sides will always be greater than the third side. Means B plus C should be greater than A, C plus A should be greater than B. So this is the condition. So let's check this. 4 plus 5, 9. 9 is greater than 6. 5 plus 6, 11 greater than 4. 6 plus 4, 10. 10 greater than 5. So this is possible. This triangle is possible. Like 3, 4, 5, same. 2, 3, 4. If you will check, these two are possible. But if you will see here, 1 plus 2 is 3. But 3 is equal to 3. 3 is not greater than 3. But for making the triangle, sum of two sides will be always greater than the third side. Sum of any two sides of the triangle will always be greater than the third side. So this was all about the sum questions which I have taken from the TNPSC group 1. More aptitude questions will be coming in upcoming videos. So follow our channel and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a nice day.